لكن قال شيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية إن كلام القدرية والمرجئة حين رده بصايا الصحابة كان في الطاعة والمعصية والمؤمن والفاسق، لم يتكلموا في ربهم وصفاته. But Ibn Taymiyyah says really these statements of the Qadariyya and the Murji'ah, these two groups of innovators, when the companions of the Prophet ﷺ refuted them, they refuted this position of theirs, those people, those Murji'ah and Qadariyyah, they were only speaking about obedience and disobedience, and the believer and the disbeliever, and the believer and the corrupt person, the wicked person. They did not speak about Allah and His attributes. Yet, their innovation first was about what we mentioned. Nothing harms you with Iman, or Allah did not decree this. The things, this came later. In the beginning, they were not dealing with Allah and His attributes. It was just dealing with Iman and Iman and wicked person and a good person, what have you. فجاء قوم من الأذكياء. The Shaykh said something here funny. So a group of smart people came about. يعني he's mocking them. They have nothing to do with intelligence. They were not really intelligent. بمن يدعون أن العقل مقدم على الوحي. Now we'll see the danger. فقالوا قولا بين القولين. قول المرجئة وقول الخوارج. قالوا الذي يفعل الكبير ليس بمؤمن كما قاله المرجئة. ولكنه وليس بكافر كما قال الخوارج. بل هو في منزلة بين منزلتين. So a group of intelligent individuals, or supposedly, came and they said, those who claim that intelligence takes precedence over revelation. يعني whatever from the revelation doesn't make sense, they use their mind. Whatever makes sense here, this is the truth. Even if it goes against the revelation. So they put forth, they favor their intellect over textual evidences. And Ibn Taymiyyah, may Allah mercy on him, wrote a compilation of books يعني mentioning يعني there's no contradiction between intelligence and textual evidences. Rather, they are in harmony with the person who really has intelligence, not the person who claims it. So what did these people say? They said, we're going to say a statement in between. Between the Murji'ah and the Khawarij. So they said, whomever does a major sin, he's not a believer. If you do a major sin, he's not a believer as the Khawarij, who used to believe anyone. If you commit zina, if you fornicate, you're no longer a Muslim. If you drink alcohol, you're no longer a Muslim.
Khawarij.
Khawarij. So these people said, if you do a big sin, you're really not a Muslim anymore. You're no longer a believer. But you're not a kafir either. You are in a position between two.
Oh.
What? Crazy stuff. You're not a believer. And you're not a disbeliever. They said you're in a stage between two. And they gave an example. كرجل سافر من مدينة إلى أخرى فصار في أثناء الطريق فلا هو في مدينته ولا هو التي سافر إليها. Like a man who was traveling between two cities. So he was in the middle. He's neither in his Medina, his city, nor is he in the one that he's traveling to. But he is in a stage in between the two stages. هذا في أحكام الدنيا. This is regarding how they treated this person regarding this dunya. You're not a believer, so we give you salam alaikum. You're not a kafir, so we consider you an apostate. And so you're not a Muslim. That's how they treat him in the dunya. But in the hereafter, their ruling regarding him, فهو مخلد في النار. He will abide eternally in the hellfire. فهم يوافقون الخوارج في الآخرة ولكنهم في الدنيا يخالفونهم. So they oppose the khawarij in the dunya, but they are in agreement with them in the hereafter. Excuse me. Anyway, so as we were saying, so they opposed the Khawarij in the dunya, but they agreed with them in the hereafter. That the person who commits a major sin, he will go to the hellfire eternally. It's crazy, man. Meaning, يعني, most of the Muslims, مع السلامة. And how many of us are really يعني, pure, mashallah, that they don't perform any sins, whether major or minor?
No, sir, he's an angel. Yeah.
Hey.
The angels.
The Shaykh says, انظر كيف تدرجت البدع في صدر الإسلام. Look how innovation gradually started to be introduced into Islam. Subhanallah. And the Prophet ﷺ warned us from way before. He said, whomever amongst you live, he will see a lot of differences. So upon you is my sunnah and the sunnah of the rightly guided khulafa after me. He warned us from innovating. But anyways, حتى وصلوا إلى الخالق جل وعلا. They kept innovating until they made it all the way to Allah عز وجل. Started innovating and speaking about Him. وجعلوا الخالق بمنزلة المخلوق. Oh, it's almost صلاة time. And they made the creation equal to the Creator. the innovation went to such an extent that they made the creation equal to the creator. يقولون كما يشاءون فيقولون هذا ثابت لله وهذا غير ثابت. هذا يقبل العقل أن يتصف الله به وهذا لا يقبل العقل أن يتصف به. So they say whatever pleasing to them. They say whatever is pleasing to them. They say this is confirmed about Allah. No, this is not confirmed about Allah. This the mind accepts that Allah may have this description, but this one, the other one you mentioned, I don't believe that Allah has this description. And I've had this يعني, conversation myself with someone who's a Muslim, who's related to me. And I was having this discussion, and wallahi, it's as he said. I told him, Allah rose above his throne. He said, my mind cannot accept that Allah will be above a throne. You know, my mind just doesn't digest it.
Logically.
Yani, Allah is much greater to be in a throne. Akhi, I said, Allah much greater, but he told you this in the Quran. It is not about what your mind can understand or what your mind can understand. This is about revelation. إِنَّ جَعَلْنَاهُ قُرْآنًا عَرَبِيًّا لَعَلَّكُمْ تَعْقِلُونَ. I've made it in Arabic Quran so you may understand. Allah revealed it in Arabic and told them in clear Arabic text in 7 different places in the Quran that Allah rose above his throne. So you come reject it because your mind, it doesn't suit you. This is how they do. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide me and guide him to the truth. فَحَدَثَتْ بِدْعَةُ الْجَهْمِيَّةِ وَالْمُعْتَزِلَةِ فَانْقَسَمُوا فِي أَسْمَاءِ اللَّهِ وَصِفَاتِهِ الْأَقْسَامُ مُتَعَدِّدَةً. So another innovation was introduced, which is the innovation of Al-Jahmiyyah, because of the one who used to, they follow with, I believe his name was Safwan ibn Jahm, or we will see. His name is, his last name is Jahm. They were called Jahmiyyah and Mu'tazila. Jahmiyyah. Jim, Ha, Mim, Ya, Ta, Marbuta. Wal-Mu'tazila. And we will see more about the Mu'tazila. And they became divided regarding the names and attributes of Allah into a number of divisions. We will stop, inshallah, right now. Because this is going to be elaborate right now.